no score. Ishii pitching, two men on. King Griffey Jr. singles to right. That brings in two. Ishii gave up a season-high 8 runs in 2 2/3. Bottom 3-4, nothing now. Runners on second and third. Ishii's pitch gets away from Paul LaDuca. Todd Walker scores. LaDuca's throw is off. Jason LaRue says, I'm coming home. And he slides in safe. Jim Tracy, don't say nothing, because we can read minds. Reds scored 12 runs for only the third time this season. Their season high is 14. They hit four homers in the game. This one from Aaron Boone, 12 for the final. Ishii threw only 35 strikes out of 72 pitches. Off the field news, Kevin Brown recovers from surgery on his lower back. He threw 90 pitches in the bullpen at Dodger Stadium Tuesday without a problem.
Facing Michael Tejera with a man on first. Rowland. Not exactly where he wanted to start. 4-6-3 DP, but he did make a nice defensive play in the first inning. Top of four, still scoreless. Second at bat, runners in first and second with two outs. Laces one into left. Fernando Vina trying to score from second. Kevin Millar with a dart. Mike Redman applying the tag. Top of five, Tino Martinez, who batted sixth after Roland. How you doing? To a near empty Pro Players Stadium, his 13th on the year. He's 2 for 4, 2 RBIs. Next batter, Edgar Renteria, and does the same thing. Goes to the left side, though. Back-to-back jacks. Renteria's 6th of the year. First of 2 homers in the game for him. Tejera gave up 3 jacks in all. Top of the 8th, rolling at the plate again with a man on 3rd. Shot to center over Preston Wilson's head. Pujols comes in to score. Roland is digging for 3rd, and he's thinking about heading home, puts on the brakes, and says, I'll stay put. I'll take that 2 for 4, 1 ribby debut. Cards win it 5-0. Lost in all the Roland hooplas that Andy Bennis won for the first time in almost a year. It was Renteria's first multi-homer game.
7 and 8 hitters in the Astros lineup. Orlando Merced, Brad Osmus, and Jeff Blom. Top of the second, no score. Jeff D'Amico facing the 6th hitter in the lineup. Merced, base hit up the middle. Next batter, your 7th hitter in the Astros lineup, Brad Osmus. Yeah, that was painful for D'Amico, but wait till the end of the game. Osmus is safe. Then again, the entire season. All right, don't get me started. 2 on for Jeff Blom, the 8th hitter. In the gap it goes. Both runners come home. Astros go up 2-0 on the Blom triple against Jeff D'Amico. Top of the 4th now, it's 5-1 Houston, 1 on for Merced. Facing Satoru Komiyama, that's a bloop. That's Merced's 2nd hit of the night. Not to be outdone, next batter. You should know this by now if you've been watching this highlight. Brad Osmus, high drive. There is no doubt about this. A 3-run home run for Osmus. And the Astros go up 8-1 at Shea. Next batter, it's Blum. Picking his spots. His 3rd hit of the night. We move on to the top of the 5th. And by the way, there are still people in the seats at Shea with a score 10-1 Astros. Runners on 2nd and 3rd for Merced. Line drive, Jeff Bagwell. Coming in, Stroh's up 11-1. 2 batters later, runners on the corners for Blum facing Mark Corey.
7.
No doubt.
Ooh.
I mean, where is that? Name another borough. Brooklyn, Bronx, anywhere. It's not in Queens. 6, 7, and 8 hitters go 11 for 18, 9 RBI, 9 runs. 16-3 the final, but...
Polar opposites. Braves major league best 67-38. The flip side, Brewers 38-67. Should be a rout, but as somebody here says, that's why they play the game. Chipper Jones, Richie Sexton, great grab. Touches first, double play. Brewers had leather and lots of it. Vinny Castilla batting, bottom 2. To deep left, Ryan Thompson though, on the case. He smacks into the wall, makes a great play. Look at the concentration. Thompson, eyes never left the ball. Great grab. Bottom 3, same score. Damian Moss on first. Rafael Furcal at the plate. What do we have here? We've got a throw to first, and it's late. But wait a minute. We've got a double play because Moss, as you'll see, he's a pitcher, and well, he basically just sort of tackles Jose Hernandez, and that's not legal. Julio Franco now, who had a 3-hit night, and here he actually it's a 4-hit night because he hit a girl with a bat. But she's tough, holds back the tears. Now top 5, Alex Ochoa batting, and what are these people doing? They're chucking bats into the same section in here. Now that's a calamity, that man's lost half a beer, but he's okay, everybody's fine. Bottom 5, still 1-0 Brewers. Javi Lopez drives one, but Mark Loretta to his knees. More great defense. They're still down, but now the Braves are ahead 3-1. Lopez back-to-back at bats, and here a bid to put the Braves up 5-1. Jeffrey Hammonds, do not seek the treasure. Oh, Lopez cannot buy a break. Meanwhile, Moss cruising. Bobby Cox compared him favorably to Tom Glavine, says he never gives in, even when he's down in the count. There he strikes out Hernandez and Machado. Now, Braves leading 3-2. John Smoltz trying to close it out. Matt Stairs grounds out to end the ball game. Smoltz ties the Braves' record of Mark Wohlers. We saw earlier in the show. 39 saves. Atlanta has won 10 of 13. Jose Hernandez for the Brewers knocked in both runs and is the first Milwaukee shortstop to have 20 home runs in back-to-back seasons ever. Hall of Famer Robin Yao never did it. Surprising.
Pedro, the Angels, he's 6-0 in his last seven starts. He owns the AL West, bottom second against Scott Spezia, one of his 9 Ks. He gave up just 2 hits on the night. Top of 5, Nomar with a 4-0 Sox lead to left center. That plate's Trot Nixon, only hit for Nomar. He's second now in the AL in ribbies with 86, tied with Giambi, bottom six. 6-6 Boston. Pedro's defense helping him out. David Eckstein, ground ball. Tony Clark, nice play, and over to Pedro. And then Ugi Urbina comes in. Adam Kennedy sends one to Tony. He makes up for his 0-for-4 performance. Urbina pitched a perfect ninth. 17 straight Angels were retired to end this one, and the Red Sox win it. Final count, 6-6. Pedro, 27-3 in his career versus the AL West. He's 13-0 against the AL this year. Boston has outscored their opponents 50-7 in their last 5 Ws. 14th shutout by a Red Sox pitcher this year that leads the majors, and they've got some help. Cliff Floyd, please pick up the white courtesy phone. He's on the move again 3 weeks after he was traded to the Expos. Montreal deals him to the Red Sox for 2 minor league pitchers. Floyd is eligible to become a free agent at the end of the season.
It's weird, you know, I mean, getting traded twice in the season is something new for me, but you know, it's the way this game rolls. You know, you got to go with the flow. And I'm going to a great situation. You know, Boston is a great team. And, it's an unfortunate situation here. I wish we had done better. The situation would have been different, but we didn't. And, you know, I played a big part of it. I didn't do as well as I thought I should have in the 50 at bats or whatever I got here. But I felt my swing starting to come around, so hopefully I can go help their team.
The Mariners begin the night tie with the Angels in the AL West. Top third, John Halama tells Bobby Higginson, tricks are made for kids. An unassisted pickoff. Halama gave up 4 runs, 10 hits, and 5 innings. Bottom four, M's down 3-1. Mike Cameron with 2 on. Smacks one. Chris Truby, diving stop, gets the out. Edgar Martinez scores anyway. Seattle cuts into the lead. Cameron 1-for-3. That's his 60th RBI this season. Bottom 10 tied at 4. Bases loaded for Mark McLemore. It's a squeeze. Desi Relaford scores the winning run. McLemore credited with the hit. M's get 14 hits in their 5-4 win. The Tigers have lost 5 straight. They're 16-38 on the road this season. Ichiro went 1-for-5 before his infield single in the 7th. He was hitless in 16 straight at-bats. His longest career hitless streak was an 0-for-18 stretch last season. The A's took the field 4 games behind the Mariners and Angels in the West. Ryan Dries with a 7.03 ERA, worst among starters in the majors. Mark Ellis off the wall and left. Ramon Hernandez tries to score. Omar Vizquel, the perfect relay to nail him at the plate. Ellis later hit his first homer in 23 games. Top 6, 3-1 Indians, bases loaded. Ricky Gutierrez singles to right. Bill Selby and Milton Bradley score. Gutierrez 1-for-4. He's hitting .275. Corey Lytle gave up 5 earned runs and 5 1/3. Bottom 9, Ellis already 3-for-4. Bloops one. Milton Bradley, play it a game. Mark Wohlers gets the final 4 outs for a 2nd save in as many days, thanks to Bradley. After not having one in over 4 years, Indians win 5-4. Cleveland's won 3 straight for the first time since winning 4 in a row from late May to early June. Couple streaks extended in this game. Omar Vizquel extends his hitting streak to 16 games, hitting .422 in that span. Miguel Tejada extends his hitting streak to 19. Longest current streak in the majors. Top.
Anti Roland. His replacement in third is Placido Polanco. Kenny Lofton leading off and getting off. Little recoil there with a home run to left center. Not a bad way to start.
Not a bad way. And one thing that Kenny really did there was stay inside and drive the ball the other way. A lot of times he'll roll over that pitch, so looks like his stroke is where he wants it.
Yorvit, Torrealba, two-run single, played Snow and brings Bell in. It's 5-0. Brett Myers done after three innings. Gave up 5 earned. Harold will have more on him shortly as well. Lofton already got a home run and got some speed still, Edge.
Telltale sign right here. The great follow-through, and you get a triple out of the box, and he knew all the way he had three. He's cruising. Like that point guard from Arizona, Kenny Lofton.
Tony Clark was a power forward in Arizona.
And who was Tony Clark's roommate? Basketball camp?
No, that was...
3-0 against Montreal this season, bottom second. Cliff Floyd playing his last game as an Expo, going out in style. His 21st of the season, he had 3 homers in 15 games with Montreal this season. Top 8, man on third, 4-3, Expos lead. Rod Barajas, ground ball to shortstop. Orlando Cabrera's throw gets away from Andres Galarraga. Steve Finley scores, tied at 4, only error in the game. Bottom 9, tied at 4. Fernando Tatis, hard ground ball to third. Matt Williams, the backhand play. From foul territory.
Wow.
Tatis 0 for 3. He's hitting 256. Bottom 10, still tied. Vlad Guerrero, in order to keep my rep up, I got to step up. His 27th. Expos win 5-4. Look at Byung-Young Kim. Just get out of here. Expos get their major league leading 23rd one-run victory this season. D-backs lose for the first time in 8 games. They had...
Roger Clemens is scheduled to pitch later this week. It just won't be with the New York Yankees. Instead, it will be in the Yanks minor league system. The big club doesn't want to rush the Rocket back from his groin injury, so Clemens will fine-tune with another rehab start. An easy decision considering the Yankees have 6 starters at the moment. One of them, Jeff Weaver, who has been awful in 4 starts and pinstripes, will start in Clemens' place Thursday at Anaheim. To Texas.
Top of the first, Aaron Maia facing Bernie Williams with a man on. Bernie taking a 3-0 fastball for strike one. Next pitch, no doubt, his 14th of the year. Bernie with a 10-game hitting streak. He drove in 3 in this game. Bernie Williams has 67 RBI despite the poor start or slow start this season. Take another look at our Sports Center strike zone. First pitch, belt high fastball, right? Second pitch to Bernie, same locale. And Bernie takes advantage against the young Texas pitcher. Bottom 1-2-1 Yanks, one on for Alex Rodriguez. Number 35 on the year, his 11th this month to lead the majors. Alex Rodriguez has 90 RBI for a last place team. Top of the 6-6-3 Yanks, Jason Giambi, 86 RBIs, his 27th home run, 8-3 Yanks. Bottom 7, same score. David Wells still on the mound facing Mike Young. Young, that's deep opposite way. Raul Mondesi, who homered in this game, also can play right field. Top of the 8th, Alfonso Soriano facing Jay Powell. Soriano, 26 home runs for Alfonso Soriano. 4 more homers, and he's the second ever Yankee to be in their 30-30 club. Bobby Bonds the first. Now, as you may know, Rafael Palmeiro is a spokesman for a well-known product.
I take Viagra.
So, bottom 8, Palmeiro facing Steve Carce. Notice the arrow, Viagra sign right behind home plate. Palmeiro. The result, number 28 on the year. Number 475 in his career. Now, we're going to show you another look at where the ball landed. The Viagra pitchman hit the Viagra sign with his home run. Coincidence? Who knows? Palmeiro's homer, not only an uplifting experience, but it was his 475th, tying Stan Musial and Willie Stargell for 20th all time. Oh yeah, the Yankees won. A-Rod's homer, his 11th this month, that was worth repeating. His 276th of his career. He's now just 1 behind Ernie Banks for 2nd all time among shortstops behind Cal Ripken. No team is hotter in the AL than the Twins, winners of 9 of the last 10, hosting the White Sox, Torrey Hunter. Out with a strain of his hip flexor. Kyle Loesch walking Willie Harris to start things off for the White Sox. Next batter, Loesch. No problem. Picking Harris off first. Look at it again. Was this a balk? Watch Loesch's left leg bend as he spins. Well, the first base ump, Gary Cederstrom, apparently missed it. First base coach Gary Pettis lets Cederstrom know about it. Harris also upset about the call in the dugout. Pettis was ejected from the game. Bottom 4 runners at first and third, 2 out. Doug Menkevich at the plate, looking for contact towards second. Willie Harris. Mark Burley gets out of the jam. Top 6, Loesch still in there. Maglio Ordonez. His 23rd of the year. It's 3-0 White Sox. Bottom nine, Burley trying for a complete game shutout. 2-1, nobody out. Bobby Kilty. Joe Creedy coming home. Throwing out Corey Koski. The shutout still alive for Burley. Your next batter. The challenge, Mike Kadire. Not much of one. 6-4-3 double play. Mark Burley gets his complete game 5-hit shutout, his third career shutout for Burley, who beat the Twins for a second straight start. He's 14 wins, tied for second best in the AL.
We go to Chicago to bring you the top five reasons the Pods beat the Cubs. Actually, reason number five has nothing to do with anything except Sammy. It's number 32, out into the bleachers, and Ronnie Woo-Woo and his folks. Cubs, woo! Sammy, woo! Cubs got three in the first, but then we'll get into the Pods reasons. Reason number four, pitcher Bobby Jones. He's 11-1 lifetime against the Cubs here. Suicide squeeze. They got two there. Now, Bubba Trammell just absolutely annihilates Mark Pryor into the Chicago Knight, and the Pods are within one, 5-4. Now, it's about Tom Lampkin. He takes over the highlight. First, he knocks one into the shrubbery, and we're all locked up at fives. Now, one more reason for Lampkin. Up the middle off Tom Gordon, into center, Davey Cruz comes in to score. Pods go up 6-5. Lampkin, as I said, he takes over the top five, and Padres win it 6-5.
Pirates, Larry Walker, Brian Giles. Walker leading his team in 8 offensive categories, while Giles leads his team in 9 categories. Hey, can't you see? All right, bottom three, man on first, Brian Giles facing Sean Chacon. The Pirates haven't scored since Friday night. The liner, Larry Walker, misplays it. Jason Kendall scores. That's 93 hours, 31 minutes, and 23 seconds later, the Pirates have scored again. 1-0, Pirates on the triple. 1-1, man on second, Larry Walker against Chris Benson. So much talent by Benson, freezing Walker. Walker 1-for-3. Benson was brilliant. Still tied at 1. Danny Nagel facing Giles now in the 8th. Man on first. Giles, opposite way down the line. It's a ground rule double. Giles was 2-for-3. 3 batters later with the bags full, 2 out. 3-0 count for Kevin Young, KY. And Nagel walks Young on 4 pitches. Giles scores. Pirates win. Benson goes 8. 3 hits allowed in 5 Ks.
Cue the fire trucks. Raul Ibanez offbeat Walker, and that's a home run. Ibanez 15th. He is hot, but the fireworks at Kauffman Stadium, they set fire to the grass outside the stadium in the field. And a gentleman with a bucket and some boots on, we got a fire! So I got a call for the gentleman whose job it is to put the flames out, and the KC Fire Department, thanks, boys, they handle the blaze. Bottom three, Kansas City down 2-1, man on second, Carlos Beltran, he spanks one out. Two-run shot, it's his 17th, and we're going to go ahead and not set off the fireworks this time. Okay, thank you. Top five. We're tied at 3, and now Toronto's bats, they begin to heat up. Vernon Wells off Chris Wilson. Vernon Wells, one of 3 Jays with 3 hits in the game. They had 17 as a team. Dave Berg, Jose Cruz Jr., Carlos Delgado all come in on the bases clearing triple. Jays win 13-4. Oh, my God, Arsenio Hall is back. John Stevens, the 17th Australian player in the Major Leagues. Arsenio, he's pleased by that. Did you know that the Major League's best team with the bases loaded, that's the Devil Rays. 481, Jared Sandberger, Grand Slam, Arsenio. What say ye? Oh, he's got a lot more. He's got a lot of mo. Devil Rays came into the game last in the American League in home runs. Sandberg hit the slam. Aubrey Huff with a solo shot. Ben Grieve, his 11th home run. Then the bottom of the 7th, Huff's 2nd. 4 home runs in the game for the Devil Dogs. Arsenio. Thank you. Top 8, Joe Kennedy. Gonna sit down Jerry Hairston. And one more time, Arsenio. Good to have you back. Quick, who leads the AL in complete games? It's a tie. Paul Byrd and Joe Kennedy.